This is the Acasus Mac Mini M4 workstation. It's an 8-in-1 dual SSD 40 gigabits a second dock, and this finally might be the Mac Mini M4 dock you've been looking for. What's up? I'm Royce, and welcome to my channel where I talk about all things film and tech. And today I'm really excited to talk about this product, the Acasus Mac Mini M4 workstation. Acasus was nice enough to send me one of their workstations to review ahead of their Kickstarter campaign that's going live on May 15th. Unless this is already May 15th or after that, then it's live now. And I'm excited to talk about this because this is a hub/dock for the Mac Mini M4 specifically that's 40 gigabits a second, USB 4. And if you're a Mac Mini owner and you've watched my channel, you know that's a big deal. So let's jump into this thing. First, we're gonna take the Acasus workstation out of its box. And there it is. You can see that silver aluminum alloy frame looks really nice. You see those grills that help with cooling and airflow. It's got three USB-A ports on the front. These slots here, one is a full SD card, the other TF card reader. Both are 4.0 card readers, so they get up to 312 megabytes a second of transfer speeds. And then on the back, we have two 1.3 display ports. On the top is the host USB-C port, and on the bottom is the 30 watt power delivery port. And on the bottom, you see the gripped feet to keep the dock standing. And now I'm going to unscrew the middle of the case that reveals the dual NVMe slots. That's right, there are two NVMe slots on this thing. And I'll be using my Samsung 980 Pro 2 terabyte SSD, and the other is my Samsung 990 Evo Plus. Yes, they're two different cards, but they're all that I have on me at the time to test this, so let's see how they turn out. Now I'm gonna insert both of these into the slots, and then place the included thermal pads on top of both. Then I'm gonna place the cover back on and screw that in. Now we're gonna unscrew the legs and take off the bottom part, and this is how we will insert our Mac Mini. Then we just have to pop the top off, and there you see we have the space that will slide our Mac Mini in. This is my Mac Mini M4 Pro, and what you wanna do is you wanna line up the power button on the bottom of the Mac Mini with the power button at the bottom of the case, and this is, try not to drop it, like I just did, everything's fine. Then I put the top back on and then screwed the feet back in. And there we go. Now we'll plug in the USB-C host connection and the power delivery so we can turn this on. Power on the Mac Mini from that side button. But we're not done. We need to press the power button on the right side as well, and that actually turns on the dock part of this case so everything works. All right, now that we have everything hooked up, let's open up the Blackmagic Disk Speed Test app and let's just test some speeds before we change anything or convert our drives over to RAID 0 so we can just see what those speeds are, because Acasus, they said before you even do a RAID, if you just want to use them as individual SSDs, we should still get speeds around 1600 megabytes a second. So let's just test that. So let's open up my Zag drive, hit start. Okay, so almost about 1400 megabytes a second of write, 1560 megabytes a second read speeds. So those speeds check out. I would actually need to format my creative drive because I actually took this from my PC. So let's just do that real quick so you just get an idea before we do the RAID. We hit erase, creative, APFS, we hit erase. And don't worry, everything is backed up, I assure you, hopefully. Nice, now that that is formatted, let's reopen up Blackmagic. Drive, creative, and hit start. And around the same, a little bit faster, actually getting over 1400 megabytes a second of write, and a little bit slower, 1520 megabytes a second of read speed. So still in the same ballpark of what's being promised. And now we'll combine them, the 4 terabyte and the 2 terabyte, and it will increase the speed because now they don't have to separate the two. And to do that, we'll go up to file, all the way down, says RAID assistant. If you've never done this before, then it'll give us some options. RAID 0, RAID 1, and JBOD or JBOD, however you want to say it. So RAID 0, it'll explain split data evenly across two or more disks without parity of information with speed as the intended goal. Or if you wanted to do a RAID 1, it makes an exact copy of a set of data on two or more disks. This type is useful when read performance or reliability is more important. So if you do kind of want to use it more as a backup and archival setup, RAID 1 will actually do that, because as you drop everything onto one SSD, all that will automatically be copied over to the other. So if one fails, you'll always have that backup. But for me, I'm living reckless. I don't care. No, I'm kidding. I have a whole other thing where I backup stuff, always backup stuff. So I'm gonna choose RAID 0, hit next, and be very careful in this part. So we're gonna make sure we select our Samsung 980 Pro and Evo. And it'll be interesting too to see the performance, because technically these are two slightly different SSD models, even though they're the same brand. So we may see some performance differences than what's promised, but they're the only ones I had, so Let's just go with it. Hit next. I'll title this Hoss's Raid Zero underscore, because I have to be professional and underscores are professional format. We'll do a PFS. And for these chunk sizes, I usually go 64. That's kind of like a nice middle ground, since I'll be using this for video editing. So that's a nice hybrid between actual performance and space optimization. So I'll hit next. It said create the RAID 0 set, Hoss's RAID 0, and it'll just tell you that creating this will erase all data from the following disk. Data still may be accessible with recovery tools, and hit create, and we'll let it do its thing. Let's open up disk speed test app again. All right, light settings, select target drive, Hoss's. Now, before I do this, remember that they are claiming that with RAID 0, we should see speeds up to around 2800 megabytes a second, which would be significant and really great. And again, what would set this dock/case apart from all the other ones that we've seen that have been limited to those 900 to 1000 megabytes a second of read and write speeds, even for NVMe drives. So let's go ahead and open this up and let's see. Woo-hoo-hoo. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh, yes. That's what I want. That's what I want to see. This is beautiful. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. 2600, a little over 2639 megabytes a second of writes, 2754 megabytes a second of read speeds. And this is with the mismatch of the NVMe drives, one being a Samsung Evo and the other one being a Pro. So we're still getting these speeds. I wish I would have had the same drives and the same capacity, because then I could have gotten the full space from that. But still, this is great for a good test, and it shows if you just so happen to already have some NVMe drives, they're not necessarily the same, but they're at least the same brand, you can still get closer to those top speeds. Now, if these drives are two completely different brands, you know, you could get something similar still, but you know, I can't account for that because I haven't been able to test it. But it's always just safe to use the same brands, same sizes, everything, just so you can kind of get that parity. But this is what we want. This is what I think all of us have been waiting to see from these docks, especially with the Mac Mini, being able to expand that storage. And if you want to do that, or if you're like me, you just want to have another convenient place to store kind of like all of my editing projects and everything off of without having to plug in an external SSD all the time, let's look at the price differences. I know we've been through it a whole bunch of times, but it's just good to put things into perspective, right? This is just the base model Mac Mini M4. That's been really popular. Comes with that 256 gigabytes of SSD storage. If we wanted to jump, because we're going to pass this 512, because nah. If we wanted to jump up to 1 terabyte, $400, an additional $400. Now let's go over to Amazon. If we wanted to get that Samsung 990 Pro, same 1 terabyte, $100. So $300 difference. And then if we wanted 2 terabytes, that's another $400. So $800 from the original 256 gigabyte storage option. If we go over here to 2 terabytes, $169.99. And if you're like me and you want the full 4 terabytes, that's $302. So still a what? Almost $500 difference in space. Granted, you do have to account for the price of the dock itself, but even with all of that combined, you're still going to come in cheaper than getting that external storage or getting that additional storage from Apple. And since we're on the topic of price, let's shift and actually talk about what the dock is actually going to cost. And you might be thinking, okay, this is USB 4. If you're thinking about other docks, price is probably going to be up there. But it's actually not, surprisingly. As I mentioned earlier in this video, the dock is not out yet. They have a Kickstarter project that they are going to run. And at the time of making of this video, their pre-launch page is up, where if you sign up, you can get the early bird pricing of only $99. Compare that to some other docks. That's all I'm going to say. $99. And that's only for the first 100 units. So you definitely want to sign up and secure your spot now. But even if you miss that, just for the other early bird pricing, it's going to be $129. And that's going to be the first 300 units. Even if you miss all of those, the regular price is $149. Again, put that into perspective, USB 4 versus the other USB 3.2 Gen 2 blah blah madness that are out today, that price is looking pretty nice. So again, sign up for the Kickstarter page so you get a chance at the early bird pricing. I'll leave a link in my description so you can check that out. And the campaign officially goes live on May 15th. The Acasus Mac Mini M4 workstation is pretty much the dock I have been looking for my Mac Mini since it's come out. As I've shown on my channel with other previous docs, and as we've talked about, as you guys have expressed in the comments, a lot of frustrations with older generation speeds. And with this, we're finally get a dock that supports USB 4. So we're gonna get faster speeds out of those NVMe slots, which actually gives it more of a purpose. And on top of that, it's a dual slot that can be expanded up to 16 terabytes. That is major. And honestly, they could have just stopped there, but they kept going. You have both SD and TF card slots that both can do 312 megabytes a second of transfer speeds. And it still includes three USB-A legacy ports for people who need those. And it's got two USB display ports. So now you can do HDMI display port or USB-C, however you want to connect to your monitor, you have more options. It's got that 30 watt power delivery and the nice cooling fan, and overall just a really nice design, kind of around the Mac Pro type designs we've seen in a lot of different cases. This one obviously a little bit beefier, a bit wider for obvious reasons. Now, the one thing that I feel like is keeping this dock, this case from being absolutely perfect, the fact that there are no additional USB-C ports on the dock itself. And you have to take up one port to plug into the dock to make everything work, which leaves your Mac Mini only with two of your USB-C ports in the back left. So you still would have to get an additional USB-C dock if you want to plug in more peripherals or drives or whatever, in addition to this case if you were to get it. Now, since that's been the case with all these other docks as well, the concept isn't as bad because at least you know you're getting more bang for your buck going for something like this. So you know whatever USB hub that you would get would just need to be those USB-C hubs, which, you know, you could probably get a little bit cheaper versus also having to get all these other additional peripherals and things like that. And I know that's still probably going to be a bummer for a lot of you. I know it is for me too, but having those dual NVMe slots does take a lot of pressure off of not having additional space to plug in a hard drive or, you know, anything else. So yeah, for me, I feel like that's the only other thing that's keeping this from being an absolutely perfect no-brainer purchase for anyone that has a Mac Mini. But if losing those ports aren't as big of a deal for you, or if you already have a dock that you can utilize with this, I highly recommend that you guys check this out. Check the Kickstarter page out, look at all the information. I've been loving mine. I've been using it for a while. And yeah, even after doing this review, I'm keeping this thing hooked up. I'm using it as my main source to edit all of my YouTube videos on now, as far as those NVMe slots. I can just have it all in there. I don't have to have that external SSD, you know, hanging off to the side or anything else. You got, you know, quick access to the power button. Yeah, got to mention it. And if I ever needed or wanted to utilize those display ports, which I do from time to time, depending on the monitors and stuff and my setup, I know I can do that now, which is really cool. So again, check out my description below. I have two links. One is to the official Acasus main page that has all the information on there. And the other one is access to their Kickstarter page, which if you're watching this on May 9th, you can sign up to get notified when the page goes live. So you can, you know, get that access to those early bird pricings. Or if it's May 15th and beyond, use a link to buy yours now. And if you're wondering if the dock interferes with your Wi-Fi signal or strength, from the tests that I've done and from just what I've experienced, I haven't noticed any significant decline with that. So I don't think you have anything to worry about putting your Mac in this dock. And that's it for this video. Hopefully you found it helpful. If so, please like and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos like this, and hit that notification bell so you can be notified when my new videos drop. Until next time, I'll catch y'all later.